a gas refrigeration problem using simple gas refrigeration cycle is being discussed here. So an aircraft is moving with a speed of 100 km per hour and uses simple gas refrigeration cycle for air condition. Ambient air and the ambient pressure and temperature are 0.35 bar and minus 10 degree respectively. So here let this be the part that we are considering. That means this is the main compressor of an aircraft and this is the turbine, and this part is used for combustion and all, and we are mainly focusing to this area, refrigerating area. So what happens is, from the atmosphere, the air will be entering through this conduit to this main compressor. So here it is given in the question, the ambient pressure and temperature are 0.35 and minus 10 degree. So we will take that as 0.35 and minus 10 degree Celsius. But we know the aircraft is moving with a speed of 100 km per hour, 1000 km per hour. That means this particular part is moved, ambient air is stagnant and this is moving with a velocity of 100 km per hour, 1000 km per hour. But if we are taking in a relative way, we can assume that the air is entering with a velocity 1000 km per hour. So we have the velocity of air, V. Now, so when enters, there will be ramming process. The ramming process means there will be an increase in pressure because of hitting of this air with this particular conduit. So then, so ambient pressure and temperature are 0.35 bar and minus 10 degree respectively. The pressure ratio of compressor. So after ramming, the air is entering into compressor. So in compressor, the pressure ratio is 4.5 in compressor and expander. Expander, we will talk about this expander later course. Now let us say the pressure ratio of compressor is 4.5. That means when the air is passing through this compressor, the pressure will be increased to 4.5 times. Then the heat exchanger effectiveness, after passing through this compressor, air is then passing through this heat exchanger. So we are using this heat exchanger because in the compressor, the pressure and temperature will be increasing. But the purpose of compressor is to increase the pressure. But along with the compression, there will be an increase in temperature. So we want to decrease that particular temperature, or we want to make the temperature as its initial one before the compression. But it is given that the heat exchanger effectiveness is 0.95. So if this temperature is, say, some T2 and this will be some T3. So we want to make this temperature coming out of this heat exchanger as T2, but it is not possible because it is given the exchanger effectiveness is 0.94. So we will get some temperature like T4. So then after that, this air will be fed through a turbine. This is the expander. So expander, look, the pressure ratio of expander is 4.5 times. So from the pressure here, it will be expanded to 1 by 4.5 times the pressure. So then the isentropic efficiencies of compressor and expander are, that means the compressor and expander will not be working in the adiabatic fashion, but there will be some efficiency changes, and that will be discussed when we are doing the problem. Now the cabin pressure and the temperature are 1.06 bar and 25 degree. That means after this expander, we are providing the air coming from this expander to the cabin. So when we are supplying it there, the pressure will be 1.06 bar and the temperature will be 25 degree Celsius. So these are the data given. So now we are asked to find the temperature and the pressure at all points of the cycle. Now look, first we will draw the TS diagram. So in TS diagram, first it is given that the pressure that is this atmospheric pressure. So let this be the pressure line. So pressure line for 0.35 bar. So it is given the temperature is minus 10 degrees. So we will select from the graph that particular temperature, minus 10 degrees Celsius. So this will be that point. So we will get this is the 1.1. So 1. So after 1, there is a ramming process. So in ramming process, there will be an increase in pressure. Let us take that after ramming, the point, let the state be denoted as 2. So the pressure at 2, this is the pressure at 2. So this is the ram pressure. Ram pressure. So from 1 to 2, the process is ramming. Since in the question there is no evidences of this ram efficiency at all, we are not considering, we are considering it, it as an ideal process. So from 1 to 2, this is ramming. Then 2 to 3 is compression. So compression, so let this be the pressure 3, compressed or compressor pressure. So in compressor pressure, we know this is 3 stated. The pressure here can be called as P3. This is P2. So P3 by P2 is 4.5. It is given in the question, from which we can select this particular line. And this is the ideal process of compression. But it is given, there is some efficiency, that is 0.8. It is given in the question, there is some efficiency. That means this is the work done, that this is the work that has to be supplied for compressing. But as there is an efficiency, that means we have to supply more work. More work means graph will be something like this. Because this work is equal to m into Cp into T3 minus T2. This m is the mass of airflow, right, that is passing through this compressor and all, this part. And this Cp is a specific heat at the constant pressure. T3 minus T2 means temperature difference between the ends of this compressor. So this is the work that have to be done. This increases means T2, anyway it will be same. From this point it will be T2. So T3 must be somewhat other point such that the work is increasing. So the point 3 will not be this one. Or the air coming out of this compressor will not be having a temperature T3, but it will have a temperature slightly more than that. Means this is T3, it will be more than T3. That is, let us take this point. So this is 3 dash. So this is how we get the point, we get the process 2 3 dash. So 2 3 dash is the this is non-ideal compression. So from 3 dash, this is the state 3. From 3 to 4, it is actually heat exchange. So in heat exchange, we are actually expecting the temperature of this air now, which is T3, have to be reduced to T2. But actually it is not happening. The temperature coming out of this heat exchanger will be somewhat more than T2. So let us take that as T4. So this is actually T2. But the 0.4 will be somewhat greater. So we can take this as T4. So we can call this as 4. Then from this 4, it is passing through an expander. So expander means, if we are considering the ideal process, then let us call this as 5. Then 4 to 5 process will be a adiabatic process. So let us take the cabin pressure as this one. Because let's say this is cabin pressure. So here 4 to 5, this is the expansion process. Again, here in the expansion process, it is given that there is an efficiency 0.8. So again, graph will be. So now this air is fed to cabin. And at cabin, the pressure is 1.06 and the temperature is 25. So this cabin pressure is 1.06 bar. And when it is fed to cabin, the temperature will be like 25 degrees. So this is the 0.6. So 0.5 is this point and 0.6 is inside the cabin. Six. So that is this one. So this is the basic idea of this problem. So in question it is given that, so we are drawing temperature entropy diagram of the question, and in question it is given that ambient pressure and air condition are 35 bar and minus 10 degree Celsius. So let this be the pressure line of point, it is 0.35 bar. So 0.35 bar is the ambient air condition. So let this be the 0.35 bar and the temperature is minus 10 degree, that is 263 Kelvin. So we are plotting that point. So this is the first point 1, that is 0.35 bar and minus 10 degree Celsius. So P1 is equal to 0.35 bar and T1 is equal to 263 Kelvin. So then it undergo a ramming process. So in ramming process, what happens is there will be an increase in pressure. So we want to get that particular pressure or that particular temperature. Let us call that point as 2. So we want to get a point 2 whose pressure is P2 and temperature is T2. Let this be that P2 pressure line. So now how we want to get that particular, this is the conduit and the air is entering with a velocity V1. We are assuming that when, and here the temperature is given as T1. We are assuming that when the air is entering this particular conduit, the velocity is reduced to 0. That means the enthalpy here, is CpT1 plus V1 square by 2. So this whole enthalpy will be CpT2, because here even if a velocity V is present, that velocity is 0. So 0 square by 2, that means this term is 0. So CpT2 is equal to CpT1 plus V1 square by 2. So this is the total enthalpy outside, then that will be is equal to CpT2, from which we can find it. T2 is equal to T1 plus V1 square by 2 into Cp. And if we are substituting the values, we will be getting the value of T2 as 301.4 Kelvin. So now we have obtained the temperature T2. Now we know 1 to 2 process. In the question there is no description about the efficiency, ramming efficiency and all. So we can assume that this 1 to 2 process, that ramming process is an adiabatic one. So we can use the formula P1 V1 raised to gamma is equal to P2 V2 raised to gamma, or there is also the formula as P2 by P1 is equal to T2 by T1 gamma by gamma minus 1. So these are the adiabatic conditions formula. So here we know P2, we know P1. So P2 is equal to P1 into T2 by T1 raised to gamma by gamma minus 1. So this P1 is given as 0.36 bar, T2 we have found it as 301.4, T1 we have 263 divided by gamma, it is given, Cp by Cv is given in the question as 1.4, that is 1.4 by 1.4 minus 1. So if we are substituting, we will get this as 0.564 bar. So we have obtained this particular pressure line, this is 0.56 bar and the temperature is 301. So we know P2 and T2 we know. So P2 is 0.56 bar. So temperature is 301.4. So this is the 0.2. So after this, what happens is the process 2-3. The process 2-3 is compression process. So in compression process, it is given in the question that if the compression is happening something like this and let it be reaching at a 0.3, then we know the pressure ratio. That is this pressure and this pressure are, that is P3 by P2, the pressure after compression divided by pressure before compression is equal to 4.5. So we already know P2 is equal to 0.56 bar. So P3 is equal to 4.5 into 0.564, from which we will get P3 is equal to 2.54 bar. So we have got this particular pressure. Now we want to get the temperature. For getting the temperature, if the process was an ideal one, then P2, here we can find this T3, that is T3 by T2 is equal to P3 by P2 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. This is adiabatic equation. Now T3 is equal to T2 into P3 by P2 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. Here we know T2 is equal to something like 301.4 into P3. P3 we know it is 2.54. And P2 is 0.564 divided by gamma minus 1, 0.4 divided by 1.4. So here we will get this particular point T3, that is 463.3 Kelvin. So we have obtained this point. Now we know an efficiency is given, compressor efficiency is given, which is 0.8. That means actually the point is somewhere here, 3'. So this is the actual process. But the ideal process is this one. So this compressor efficiency means the ideal work that we have to supply through the compressor, that will be always less than the actual work. So the ideal work is M into Cp into T3 minus T2 divided by actual work is M into Cp into T3 minus T2. So this will cancel. That is equal to 0.8. It is given in the question. So we know T3 minus T2. So T3 minus T2 by 0.8 is equal to, we are taking this that side. So T3 minus T2, from which if you are substituting the values of T3, T2 in the equation, we will get like this. T3 minus 301.4 is equal to 161.9 divided by 0.8. That is T3 minus T2. T3 means it is given in the question as 463.3 minus T2. T2 is 301.4. That is 161. That is obtained as, so from which T3 is equal to 301.4 plus 161.9. That is equal to 503.8 Kelvin. So we have obtained T3. So that is 503.8 Kelvin. Now we are able to obtain T3. Now four. So if the process were an actual one, we will be reaching a temperature that is equal to 2, but the process is not actual. That means the temperature that we are obtaining 4 will be somewhat higher than 2. So in the actual process, the heat exchanger could have been, in the actual process, the heat exchanger could have been MACP into T3 minus T2. But this is the ideal heat exchanger. In ideal heat exchanger, after the heat exchanging process 3-4, the temperature of the air coming out of the heat exchanger will be having a temperature T2. So this is the ideal heat exchanger. But actually, the temperature is like T4. So this is the actual case. This is the ideal case. So this is the actual case. This is the ideal case. So actual divided by ideal, we will get the efficiency. So T3 minus T4 by T3 minus T2 is equal to 0.95. Heat efficiency is given. We know the value of T3, T2. So if you are supplying, we will get T4. And that T4 can be obtained as, if you are substituting values, T4 will be obtained as, so here 0.95 is equal to 503.8 minus T4 divided by 503.8 minus 31.4. So from here T4 is equal to 311.5 Kelvin. So we have obtained this 34 is equal to 311.5 Kelvin. Now from 4
it enters the expander. So in expander, again there will be a pressure reduction. And in heat exchanger process, that is this 3-4 process is a constant pressure process. That means the temperature will be 2.54 itself. So that's why we have drawn that in the constant pressure line. So now in the expander, again pressure will be decreasing. And in the question it is given, P4 minus, let the next point, the cabin pressure be P5. So P4 minus P5 is given as 4.5. Now P4 we know 2.54, P5 we have to find. So 2.54 divided by, so P5 is equal to P4 by 4.5. So that is equal to, that is equal to something like, so after considering the heat exchanger efficiency, we will get the air coming out of the heat exchanger will having a temperature 311.5. So now we can call next process is this air will be entering through an expander. So we can call that process as 4-5. And this 4-5 process is an expansion process. If it were ideal, then it will be a adiabatic process. So we can use the formula T5 by T4 is equal to P5 by P4 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. This is because here we, this one is the pressure, cabin pressure. So cabin pressure, it is given in the question 1.06, and P4, that we know it is 2.54 divided by 1.4 minus 1 by 1.4 is equal to T5 by T4. T4 we already know, from which we can find the T5 is equal to 243 Kelvin. So now we have, so this cabin pressure is 1.06 bar, and that is given in the question. 1.06 bar is, look, this is 0.504. So 1.06 will be above this particular line. So this is 1.06 bar, and if the process were ideal, it will be like this 5. And that particular temperature is 243 Kelvin. But anyway, it is given in the question, it is not ideal. But the efficiency is 0.8. So the process will be somewhat like this. And we can call this point as 5 dash. So T5 dash minus T4 by T5 minus T4 is equal to 0.8. If we are substituting the value of 4, T4 and T5, we will get T5 dash is equal to 256.7 Kelvin. So we have obtained 5 dash this point. Now this is then fed to the cabin. So at cabin, the temperature is given as 25 degree. So here we know this is the temperature, but at the cabin it is 273 plus 25, that is 298 Kelvin. So it will be somewhat this point. So this is the cabin pressure, let us call it as 6. So now we have obtained T6. T6 is the cabin pressure. Now the question is, we want to find the mass flow rate. So for finding the mass flow rate, it is given the ton of refrigeration is something like 100. So ton of refrigeration is something like 100 ton of refrigeration. 100 ton of refrigeration means, so we know MA into CP into T6 minus T5 dash, that is T6 minus T5 dash, this is the T6 minus T5 dash means the refrigerating effect. MA into CP into T6 minus T5 dash, this much air is used. So this is the refrigerating effect, that is the heat absorbed. That heat absorbed will be is equal to the ton of refrigeration, that is 100 ton of refrigeration, that is 2 ton into 100. So from which we have, we know CP is equal to MA is equal to 1.005. T6 we have already found, it is T6 it is given in the question. T5 dash we have found. Now 2 ton into 100. So if you are substituting and going in a way, we will get MA is equal to 506 kilogram per minute. Now we are asked to find T2, volume entering at compressor. Volume entering at compressor, P2 V2 is equal to MA into RT2. So R we know, T2 we know, P2 we know, MA also we know. So V2 is equal to MA, MA is equal to 506 into R, R is equal to 287 into 301.4 divided by 0.564 bar, so into 10^5. So we will get this is the volume in minute, because we are having this MA in minute, so that is equal to 776 meter cube per minute. So this is the volume entering in compressor. So this is how we draw the general diagram from the question, and we solve this by using this adiabatic equation. Then we will be considering the efficiencies of expander and compressor. Then here a heat exchanging effectiveness is also coming into place. So that's how we do the problem.